down with the ideas and attitudes in your videos, man. So first, I guess we should start off by introducing you guys. Everybody knows y'all as Dos Effects, but what are your actual names?
The Books in Reverse is in the house.
Yeah.
Kick it the crazy, Jay-Z kicks some verse.
Okay, so just let me make sure this is clear. Your name is?
Crazy Drazy.
Crazy Drazy and?
The Books.
The Books?
Yeah, you got to figure it out now.
The Books.
The Books.
Scoop. There we go. The Books.
Word is born.
Books back with Scoop. And where you do from? You out of Brooklyn, right?
True.
What part of Brooklyn?
All right.
All right, I'm going to die. And my man over here is from?
Jersey.
New Jersey's in the house.
Part, man. Give him props.
I'm from T-Neck, kid.
T-Neck. And I guess everybody's really, you know, one of the things that's exciting about you guys is a new lyrical style in the rap game, that diggity-diggity kind of flavor. And what's the deal with that?
That's just us, you know what I mean? It's like a lot of people think that we sat down and thought of a whole new concept to come up with, but it wasn't really like that. It's like we had the style for a while, but now it's just at its developing stages, you know what I'm saying? More of an advanced thing. So we couldn't have came out any other way. That's just Dos Effects, you know?
And then the whole idea to do your videos, like we just saw your first video, they want effects, like in the sewer. I mean, that's...
Yeah, that's basically how, you know, we see hip-hop. You know what I'm saying? It's, you know, on the underground tip as far as we're concerned, you know what I'm saying? So that's basically how we want to freak.
So we are underground. It's a low-life situation. Your like TV Raps giving you that raw flavor. So let's roll into a video about, you know, two kids that I love a lot.
Who's that?
Kids that discovered y'all. EPMD, Eric.
The kids from the Boondocks.
Yeah.
Like that
flavor?
Like that.
Notice how the train came in right on cue? It's not easy to make that happen in New York, but it can happen when we want it to happen. EPMD, we just saw their video a little while ago, Crossover. How did they find you, dude?
Well, what happened was Dre and I, we were going to Virginia State University, and we were in our junior year, and EPMD, they were coming through town on their business as usual, their promotional tour.
Yeah.
And they were hosting a rap contest about 20 minutes away from where we went to school at. So we had done a demo about a month before that.
Mm.
So we would just went down to the club where they would be, you know, where they were holding the contest at. Threw the demo tape in, you know.
So was it like that EPMD song, please, 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 please listen to my demo?
Yeah, you might as well say that, you know what I'm saying? Because we was definitely trying to get on.
So was the lyrical flavor similar to what y'all are executing now, the complex jazz-like twist on the words?
When we met up with Eric Powers?
Yeah, I mean, on that demo.
It was in his process.
It was in the process.
It was in his process. We performed.
Matter of fact.
One of the songs that's on the album.
Right.
When they discovered us. So it was in this process of, you know, developing.
Developing.
As we went along, you know.
You know, the thing that's real interesting to me, just talking to you, is a lot of intellect involved, which I think is great, because it's a lot of seeming contradictions. You know, you guys got a specific look, which is very down and underground, but then a lot of intellect. And I guess a lot of people out there who don't know rap that well can't see the connection between a lot of these things. You went to college and studied psychology, I understand.
Yeah. When I went in, I was a psychology major my freshman year. And then I switched my junior year to English.
And you've always majored in English.
English, right.
How do you feel? I mean, obviously, you know, you have huge vocabularies, but how do you work your school knowledge, your education from school, into your lyrical flow?
You know what it is? It's like we don't really have a system of doing anything. You know what I mean? It's like I guess we just so happen to use phrases that may have come from like an English class or something that we've learned in the past, but it's not done intentionally.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, after we see it, after we write it, or after we hear it, we'll think back like, oh man, I learned that from such and such. Okay, now I know where I got that from.
Yeah.
But it's not done intentionally. But it's there though.
Is it obvious to you guys like that is a jazz connection between the lyrical flow, which is almost making it more musical, like rearranging the whole patterns of the rap?
I don't know if you want to call it. Well, some people say we
to a jazz like, improvisational flow.
Yeah, we use like
a chance.
We do use, you know, some jazz loops and stuff like that. But as far as the whole flow, it's like we just have a hip hop flow. You know what I'm saying? Anything that it takes to make it hip hop and make it sound fat, that's just us.
Yeah. All right, well, we're going to roll into a video right now. You know what the video is, right?
Oh, yeah.
Something from Too Short.
Too Short.
Something brand new
West
from
Coast.
Too Short. West Coast style.
Like that.
It's like that on your MTV Raps. We'll be back with more
Dos
Effects.
You know what I'm saying?
And maybe get them to do a little freestyle.
Thing. We put our emphasis on lyrics, freestyle, strictly. Sewage.
Yo, MTV Raps with Dos Effects, and I think they want to go solo on the freestyle tip.
Mike, check a one. Come get some of this.
check a mic, check a one.
Straight from the sewer.
Yo, it's like this, so I'ma kick a little freak.
What's up?
You know what I'm saying?
Kill it.
Check it out, y'all. Bonzai.
What?
Take a divide, George, I think
yeah.
I got it.
What?
Blast off, rocket, punt it,
yeah.
I block it.
Huh.
You hooligan, I'm doing them.
What?
I pump just like a rough stick.
Yeah.
Enough for it. Bust it.
Huh.
Look, but do not touch it, but behold
what?
Look at the way I float. Soldier.
Yeah.
I be the ill-funk freak up.
Custer.
The ism roll up.
Yeah.
I grip
what?
Like elastic.
Ooh.
Drastic, fantastic.
Yeah.
Tisket, a task.
Slam dunk,
slam dunk the basket. Ball.
What?
All.
Yeah.
Temperature. Chip. Golly, golly, golly. Get your adverbs here.
On your MTV rap, boy. That's a fact.
I don't know. It's like the hip hop, the abstract, the pop. I mean, just flavors from a lot of different places. Is the Dos Effects system right about now. As we hang underground with them on Yo MTV Raps, we're going to roll into a video. Something new from my man Scarface, you know, from that Texas flavor. Yo MTV Raps, hang out, y'all, as Dos gets busy.
I flip the flat. More of that.
Want me out of the game, cause they don't know if I walk again. Now tell me what that deuce like. Messed up myself for good cause I was wrapped up in the street life.
Time for us to do a jam, we're influenced by the track, you know what I'm saying?
When
we hear the track, that basically motivates us to write, you know. We don't go and sit up in any mountains or anything like that when it's time to do, you know, any lyrical works and stuff.
A lot of people think that we're, you know, so different from human beings, you know what I'm saying? But it's like we're normal. You know, we do everything that normal hip-hop artists do. We just sit down and write our music. You know what I'm saying?
We want people to get to know our music. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Get to know our music, and they could probably dig us later.
But
you know what I'm saying? But
we cool, though. You know what I'm saying?
We chill.
We cool.
Town, Yo MTV Raps with Dos FX.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? And we want you to know they invited us to meet with them underground.
Word.
We are beneath Riverside Park, Upper West Side.
Can't tell too much, man.
Well, anyway, we underground somewhere in the city.
True.
With Dos FX. And you know, one of the things I like about your whole vibe, the whole look and the aesthetic in the video is the first video you had live rap. And in the video we're getting ready to see, you have a real alligator.
Yeah.
And me and my producer, Jack Benson, we were at the Apollo when you guys did one of your first shows early this summer. You made the audience yell straight out the sewer.
Right.
The rats, the alligators, tell me about that vibe.
I mean, when we do a show, we just want everyone to basically be a part of our show. You know what I'm saying? We like a lot of crowd participation. So being that we're coming straight from the sewer, if you can't be here with us, then the next best thing is to see the video. And when we perform, you know, yelling straight from the sewer, guess it sort of puts you there with us.
As far as other people in rap, let's say people have that gangster vibe, people got that trying to rock a Mac Daddy thing, people trying to rock a conscious vibe, how would you place yourselves, you know, when you stand on the stage and yell straight out the sewer?
Right up there with them, you know what I'm saying? It's like everybody's representing something, you know what I mean? A lot of people, they want to represent as far as being, you know, fly, cool, and whatever, but that's just making hip-hop more diverse, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So we just coming straight from the sewer. That's
how we like just have a different angle, you know what I'm saying?
And I'm really curious about lyrically. It's almost like watching a film, and people are just flashing images, like, more par sausages, mom, please, or you do the hokey pokey. These are like little pieces of memory from my mind, at least.
I guess that's what Dos FX, that's the secret behind it. I don't know if you want to call it that, but what we're doing is we're touching on something that everybody can basically identify with, you know what I'm saying? It's bugged how in the same day, a 3-year-old or a 5-year-old come up to us, and then a 70-year-old come up to us, and they'll quote the same lyric, you know what I'm saying? So, I mean, I guess we're doing something right, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, we're doing something
so that's
right.
Cool.
And in the line of doing something right, what do you guys plan to do in the future? What's coming up?
As far as us on the solo tip, yo, you could just be looking for more sewage, you know what I'm saying? The second album will be a continuation
of 11. So it's like that.
Oh, the first one. Word.
more sewage from Dos FX on Young TV Raps. And as we start to get restless, we gonna get ready to roll into that video. And we gonna take a walk through this environment with Dos. What's that video, baby?
Straight from the sewer.
MCB, what rap?
And it's like that, Joe.
From the sewer,
word is born.
With the skills, when you're balling the chip. When my niggas from the bell, I was running it like a trooper. Had to try to play the score game. Had it going on with the mother, I was all that.
What's a party without a disco ball?
Yeah.
A headbanger's ball, of course, where the punches always smite. The countdown to the ball is up next, followed by headbanger's ball. Stay tuned.
And now I'm outie. Yeah. And then this nigga tried to foul me back. Super tough. What the floor wanted to flip. I'm trying to dip. All of a sudden I had the shit. So I dipped to the stool. Got control of the shit because it. Flip, pepper, hit.